بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. دير دكتور حازم، دكتور يحيى، دير colleagues, thanks for your attendance. Today we will talk about fugoplasmin bleed capsulotomy in infantile cataracts. We'll talk a brief introduction about congenital cataracts and what's in the lens can be visually significant or not stable, progressive, congenital or acquired, unilateral or bilateral, partial or complete. The incidence is 6 in 10,000, 10% of childhood blindness. The infantile cataracts are a significant cause of treatable blindness in infantile in infants worldwide. The population-based studies have estimated that the prevalence is between 1 and 13 cases per 10,000 persons. Most are congenital, but some cataracts may not manifest at birth, but in the first year, making the term infantile cataract more inclusive. Classifications: bilateral, unilateral, sporadic, no family history, ocular anomalies, persistent fetal vasculature. Causes are identified in only 10% of cases. There is acquired cataracts, also the classifications. There's a lot of classifications. This is morphological classification for anterior-polar, cerebellar, cortical blue dots. The treatment mainly is surgery and cataract extraction or intraocular lens implantation. For visually significant cataracts, we are doing it by 6 weeks of age now. Bilateral cases are 1 week apart, but in our practice can be done in one setting with complete new surgical set and sterilization for each eye. That you are changing your gown, you're changing your gloves, make your scrub nurse re-scrub again, and change the cassette of the machine, everything as a new eye. To be done. Non-visually significant cases, it need careful observation and possible pupillary dilatation. In simple cases with large dense lens of its proximity to the posterior capsule, definite interface with normal visual development, this needs surgery from the beginning. But for complex and intermediate cases like moderate lens opacity, coexistence of refractive errors and amblyopia, non-nystagmus, visual and functional performance, poor retinoscopic red reflex, central lens opacity more than 3 mm, poor retinal visualization with direct ophthalmoscope, presence of relative afferent pupillary defect, is a poor prognostic sign, and progression of the lens opacity. Unilateral congenital cataracts versus bilaterality, delayed diagnosis due to contralateral normal eyes, associated ocular defects as microphthalmos, foveal hypodysplasia, strabismus, postoperative enlargement of the peripheral field of vision, best corrected visual acuity less than 20/70 in involved eyes, can use mydriatic cycloplegic drops if the lens opacity is mild and central and photophobia is aggravated, reading glasses often necessary. Historical review about the cataract management in children started with optical iridectomy, then dissection and needling, through and through dissection, linear extraction, aspiration of the cataract, irrigation aspiration techniques, intracapsular cataract extraction, and automated vitrector, and then phacoemulsification. Specific techniques, two main approaches exist for the removal of cataracts in children, which are pars plana approach and limbal approach. Now it become in favor for the limbal approach because it allow better preservation of the capsular bag for the in-bag IOL placement. The capsule management in pediatric cataract surgery, why the anterior capsulorhexis is difficult in children. There is an extreme elasticity of the anterior capsule, higher fracture toughness, positive vitreous pressure, reduced scleral rigidity, difficult visualization of the capsule, and sometimes poor mydriasis, and there is more tendency for the capsular rexis extension, the runaway rexis. The technique for pediatric capsulotomy is, first of all, is manual continuous curvilinear capsular rexis and can owner anterior capsulotomy, vitrorexis, and bipolar radiofrequency capsulotomy, and then the fugoplasma blade anterior capsulotomy. How the fugoblade works? The fugoblade is a lightweight handheld radio frequency electrosurgical device. It generates cloud plasma particles around tiny filaments about a thick of a human hair. This is at the end of the handpiece. This is the tip, it's capsular rexis tip, and this is the handpiece, and this is the main console of the fugoplasma blade. The plasma particle dissolved by the molecular bonds of the materials they come in contact with, creating an incision 20 to 40 times sharper than an incision made with a diamond blade. And this is approved by the U.S. and Food and Drug Administration's FDA approval. How it will help us in pediatric cataract surgery? It will help us in anterior capsulotomy. It will make a large capsulotomy, managing a posterior capsular problems, posterior capsular plaques removal, cutting fibrovascular membranes, iridotomy, bubuloplasty, capsulotomy in a subluxated lens, and there is no need for staining at all. The unique features of the child eye, however, have created the need for a variation in adult procedures. And at times, completely different techniques have been needed to ensure safe and effective cataract removal and stable central fixation of the IOL in the child. The surgical technique. First, I have to mention something that the preoperative consideration. You know, in all cases, we are doing it under general anesthesia, and there was a significant notice. We noticed it during doing the IOL calculation because, you know, you have to anesthetize the patient, the child first, and then you will do the IOL calculation inside the OR. And so the A-scan is affected by the cardiac monitors, leads, so it has to be turned off. And this is a video to show you how it will be affected. You see it is now, it's ranging from 23.8 to 23.2, and then the monitor is working now. See, when the monitor stops, it will jump up to 24.30, and it will become stable. As you see, now it's stopped, it's 30, yeah, between just 10 up and down only. So it becomes stable, and you can get freeze, but if the monitor is working, you will not have auto-freeze at all. So you have to take consideration of this. This is a technique where I'm using the diamond knife for making a corneal tunnel. This will help me in doing the capsular rexes, IA, IOL implantation. I will not make the smaller incision because at the end you will enlarge it for doing IOL, the implanting the IOL. Why make it difficult from the beginning and make a small incision? Just do your regular incision. And at the end, you will make just one suture at the tunnel and one suture at the paracentesis. And this is, we can do it by 10 of Vicryl, and this will be absorbed and it will not be removed. Fugue blade capsular rexes, this is the fugue blade and this is the tip of the capsular rexes. We are using, as I said, no need for staining. It is very easy, safe, fast, done through a corneal tunnel. The cut power, you have here two parameters, the cut power and the cut intensity. The cut power is medium and the intensity from 4 to 6. As you see, this is the rexes done by the fugue blade. Then we are doing hydro dissection. Sometimes you are not doing hydro delineation because if we have posterior polar cataract, you can get posterior capsular tear. So it's better to do the hydro delineation only. And then we are doing the lens matter aspiration. We can use the fecotube or irrigation aspiration through the tunnel, and so you will have a very stable AC, no need for AC maintainer or anything. Then we are doing cortical cleaning by doing the IA by manual irrigation aspiration. At the end, we are doing posterior capsular rexes by the fugue blade again. As you see, this is the posterior capsular rexes. This is the anterior one. And this will help in removal of any capsular opacification or any capsular plaques present. Then we are doing anterior vitrectomy, anteriorly, total anterior approach through the tunnel, through the posterior capsular rexes, we are doing the vitrectomy. And then we are doing intraocular lens implantation. We are using the Royal injector. This will help you to use your both hands because you can direct the haptic with the second instrument away from the posterior capsular rexes, not to be engaged inside it. And then at the end, we are injecting intracameral triamcinolone. This is injected at the end of the surgery. It's 1 milligram in 0.1 milliliter to guard against postoperative inflammation. And this is the sutures at the end of the surgery. Vision numbness 25 eyes was done by this technique from February 2008 to April 2010. The follow-up period is from 1 to 26 months. All patients were visually improved, regaining their central fixation, no postoperative uveitis or posterior adhesion to the IOL. In conclusion, correct management is essential to prevent permanent visual loss, and there is early detection. The early detection within the first months of life is very important. The new advancement in surgical tools as Fecoblade, Feco machines, IOL materials give us a great help in doing a very safe, mostly complication-free congenital cataract surgery with marvelous results. And this is a video. Here, this is the corneal tunnel. And this is the Feco tip, as you see. Now we are doing the capsulotomy. As you see, it's very easy, very fast, very safe. You have bubbles that you will delineate the cut in front of you. Can complete it in one direction. You can do it in both directions. This is one of the cases. The second case, you will see it. A very nice, it was like an intumescent cataract. See here what happened? It's like a rupture of the capsule. But the capsule relaxes, the Feco blade is still, you have a very good edge that it will not tear around, or it will not extend. Then hydrodelineation, as you see, I am not doing hydrodissection because this is just a posterior capsular opacity. You can use the Feco tip, as I said, in nuclear removal. As you see, the cortex is still adherent because it is not hydrodissected. This is the posterior capsular opacity still present. You can use also the irrigation aspiration tip for lens aspiration. It's very soft, very soft cataracts. It's very quick maneuvers. Then irrigation aspiration to clean the cortex by manual irrigation aspiration. At the end, you still have the capsular opacity as you see. Now I'm trying to polish it, but even it is not cleaned. Then doing the posterior capsular relaxes. As you see, it is very easy. You can see it was good focusing. And this is the plaque removed. Then from the posterior capsular relaxes, doing vitrectomy, anterior vitrectomy. Why not use the vitrector? You know the vitrector, you cannot control the edges of the capsular relaxes. But with this capsulotomy, you have a controlled opening, and then you can do your anterior vitrectomy and keeping the bag very stable and very good relaxes anterior and posterior. This is the vitrectomy. Now IOL implantation. It's Acrisof IQ. As you see, it's well centralized. Then viscoelastic removal. You see the IOL is very centered, and you have very good anterior and posterior relaxes. And then injection of the intracameral triamcinolone. And you have the sutures. And this is the end of my talk. Thank you.